All our guests, but when you band about that figure, say, and move the epic grace. Hallelujah. Maybe me show my gama, God has and move the nonke Camelengos. Hallelujah. Chapter 40, verse number 23, chapter 41, verse number 9. Say, like a man is in us. Hallelujah. Our topic today will be descending ladders of greatness. Hallelujah. Descending ladders of greatness. There are many people who are poor today, who are not where they are supposed to be. Because they were blind and they did not see the ladders of greatness. Let's read Genesis 40, verse number 23. Praise the Lord. Chapter 41, verse number 9.
As Kati in Kosi, it took the lady 70 Yafagamin and Enfuna Eva Peggy Betty Wa Ejade, Lady Sandy Nemfuna in Gaz. Mabusugunya Sobabi, Sapuza, Leno Nadelo Pupo, Ladin and Casero Yard. Sassina Lomunium Heperu, Labesan Nani, as the 77 Bogaz. Sati Nasim Chela Lamapuko Efu, was in the Gain Casero, Leno Nadelo. Nangempela konke kwendeka njengoba abesishelile. Mina ngabuyiselwa emsebenzini wami, yena wajutshelwa inthambo. Ngakho uFaro wathumela kuthi kulave Josepha wakhishwa masinyane ejele. Wathi kube ahule esilevu, agcokele etinye timpahla, wase ulethwa kuFaro. Faro wakhuluma kuJosepha wathi, ngiphutsile. Kodwa kude noma munye lonemandla ekungichazela ngaleliphupho. Kodwa sengivile ukuthi wena uthi ungalandziswa ngeliphupho, ulichaze njengoba linjalo. Josepha waphendula wathi, akusimi inkosi, kodwa nguNkulunkulu lotawunika Farao inchazelo lengeliyo.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Father, we bless you for your word. I pray that you speak to us like never before. In the name of our precious Lord Jesus. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Where we are reading, people of God, it is a story of Joseph when he was inside prison. The Bible says, when he told his father a dream that he had at night, he said, I saw the sun and the moon and 11 stars bowing down before me. Then the father gave an interpretation for that dream. He said, you are going to be leader above all of us. Let me tell you this, people of God, dreams do come to pass. Amen. God speaks through dreams. And dreams do come to pass. Whenever God speaks through a dream, most of the time the dream comes in dark sayings or in ununderstandable things. Then you need the grace to interpret that dream for you to get the message that the Lord is communicating to you. If you can't interpret the dream, then you need somebody who has the grace to interpret dreams. And if you don't have the interpreter, you can stay with a very big destiny locked because there's no interpreter. If you don't have somebody to tell you what the Lord is saying, You can be reading a book and not understanding like that man in the New Testament. Where he was reading about Jesus. The Bible says Peter came to him and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" The man says, "I don't understand what I'm reading." Then Peter says, "It is Jesus that Isaiah is talking about."
What's
Then the man said, "Why don't you baptize me now? Because in the word comes understanding. And in understanding comes revelation. Then revelation determines your altitude. Revelation determines your elevation. In any area of your life, where you don't have revelation, you cannot be elevated in that area. If you don't have revelation about faith, then your faith cannot help you. Listen to this. The level of your revelation determines the level of your elevation. Your spiritual growth is determined by the revelation that you have about Jesus. Praise the Lord. Now, Joseph has a dream. He tells the father interprets the dream. Hallelujah. But the brothers were jealous because of the dream. Whenever you have a dream, people around you will be jealous of you. Not because you are living in the dream, but because you have a dream. Now there's a difference between having a dream or dreaming and living in the dream. There are years between him seeing a dream and him living a dream. But him living in the manifestation of the dream was determined by the steps he took along those years. The brothers were jealous of him. But one thing they did not see is that he said, "I saw 11 stars. And every star was shining, people of the Lord." And they did not understand that they were also stars, but they were shining differently from him. If you know who you are, if you know you are a star, then you cannot be jealous of another star. Because you will shine your way, I will shine my way. Shine your shine, I will shine my shine. Then let us shine together. There's no need to be jealous of another. If you know your value, if you know who you are, people of God, listen to this. Joseph said, "I saw 11 stars." It means all of you, my brothers, you are stars. But let us shine in our own way of shining. We are blessed differently. Then our journeys are not the same. Your journey is not my journey. Hallelujah. But the Bible says, they were jealous of him. They put him in a pit. They wanted him to be devoured by lions or animals in the pit. But the Bible says, he went on to Potiphar's wife. Potiphar's house. When he was in Potiphar's house, the wife to Potiphar tempted him, wanted to sleep with him. And he ran away. What Joseph ran away from is what Samson did not run away from. And what killed Samson saves Joseph. Don't choose well. Hallelujah. Then you must choose well. What killed Samson did not kill Joseph. Same temptation. But the way you address or you approach that temptation determines either you reach your destiny or not. The wise can hear me now. Give God some praise. Now Joseph was arrested. He was accused falsely.
When we qala la ngenalo.
And when he was in prison,
nangasejeleke.
The Bible says,
lithi iBhayibheli.
There were two officers from the palace.
Bekune maphoyisa lebekasuka ePalace.
That were arrested with him.
Lekaboshwe naye.
Praise the Lord. Then he saw them in the morning. That they were not happy. Now he approached them and asked them, "My brothers, what is wrong with you?" Then they said, "We had dreams." They told him the dreams. Then he interpreted the dreams. You know the story. Hallelujah. Now the Bible says in Genesis 40, verse number 23, the chief butler did not remember Joseph. There are people that will help today and they will never remember you. They will never thank you. That's why when you are helping people, don't expect them to thank you. Help them for the sake of your heavenly accounts. That must be deposited. Hallelujah. Now the chief butler forgot about Joseph. There are people that you helped. There are people that you encountered in life who are supposed to help you, but they forgot about you. There are people who are supposed to elevate you, but they forgot about you. Today I want us to pray that whosoever has forgotten about you, may the Lord cause them to remember you. In the mighty name of Jesus. I'll be very brief in today's message because I want to bless somebody. Today I pray for you. Everybody.
Okay.
That is the door in the spirit. Everybody. That carries your key to your destiny. I pray. May the Lord cause them to remember you. Listen to this. Our topic today says, discerning ladders of greatness. What is a ladder? A ladder is an object that has got many steps. And its purpose is to lift one from the lower level to a higher level. A ladder will take you from nowhere to somewhere. A ladder can be a person. A ladder can be a job. A ladder can be a brother. A ladder can be your pastor. A ladder can be anything that God can use.
You.
One day the Bible says Moses was by the well. He found girls that were watering sheep. Girls that were watering sheep and goats. And the Bible says he helped them. Because the other people who were there, the shepherds, were fighting them. Every time they were going to water their sheep, they were delayed from going back home. Because there were shepherds that were blocking them. Then Moses came to help them. But when they went back home, they forgot about Joseph. They forgot about Moses. Now the Bible says the father asked, "Why did you come early today?" Because I know for sure that in this family nobody gets global
dance.
Why have you married today? Because I know in this family nobody gets married. Why did you get a good job today? Because I know in this family nobody gets a good job. Then the girl said, "There is a prophet in every grace."
But in the prophet was
saying, "That is great for us." Then he says, "Go call him, let him come to Israel." This Moses was a ladder for them to reach where they are going. Hallelujah. He was a ladder, but some people will use a ladder. And when they are up there, they will throw away the ladder. Don't throw away a ladder because you might need it on your way down. Listen to this. Life is in stages. Life is in levels. Sometimes life will put you in Potiphar's house. It will be head over all the other slaves. But the same life can take you to prison. Where you are nobody. where you are living in a dungeon, that you need another prison to be a ladder to take you up there. Most of the time, people of God, ladders cannot be recognized. Ladders are like useless beings. Ladders can be a prisoner inside prison in the same level as yours. But tomorrow the same person who is a prisoner today can be your step ladder tomorrow. The same person who is a nanny in your house can be a step ladder tomorrow. The Bible speaks of a nanny in Naaman's house. Naaman had lepros. Then the nanny said, let my king go to a prophet in Israel. The nanny was a ladder for Naaman to get healed. Everybody can be a ladder in your life. But the problem with many people is that we are lacking discernment. We are not able to discern ladder sent by God in our lives. We are not able to see the person that God has sent for our breakthrough. If Naaman neglected the nanny, Naaman was not going to be healed. You might be where you are today because you are neglecting a ladder by your side. You might be where you are today because your eyes are blind to the ladder. But today, not today, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ, may God open your eyes for you to see the ladder that is by your side. The ladder that God has put by your side. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Listen to this. As life is in stages and levels, nobody remains in one level forever. If you see me driving a small car today, if you see me walking on my foot today, it doesn't mean I will remain there forever. More especially people called by God. More especially me and you, sons of every grace. I say, more especially you, sons of every grace. We might be where we are now, but we are not going to remain where we are. This prisoner was a prisoner for a short time. We might be prisoners together. We might be treading on foot together. But tomorrow I might give you a lift. Because life is in stages. And God blesses he wants to bless. And when he blesses man, he does not consult a neighbor. When he blesses man, he does not consult your eyes. When God blesses anybody, he consults the council of heaven. And when he blesses you, nobody can thwart the blessing. Nobody can block the blessing. For our God is a living God. I say our God is a living God. Our God is a living God. Where he says yes, nobody can say no. He's the same yesterday. He's the same today. He's the same to forever. We don't serve a dead God. Our God is alive. In the name of Jesus Christ. When God says yes, nobody will say no. And I decree and I declare that today you are shifting levels. Today you are shifting addresses. Today, not today, your profile is changing. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Today, not today, the Lord is changing your level. Yesterday, you were a prisoner, but today, you are rising up. The Lord is opening your eyes. The Lord is giving you discernment. may see your ladders. Epic grace. You are rising this year. Epic grace. There's a ladder set for us. There's a ladder set for us. We are rising in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We are rising in the name of Jesus. I want us to pray now.
Hallelujah.
I want us to pray the center of it.
As a soul minister of Tanaka.
You must be able to discern ladders of your greatness. Most of the time, diamonds are packaged in small packages. Yes, their value is too big. The value is too big, but they are enclosed in small packages. Most of the time when God wants to do something great, He will not use the already great, but He will pick what is nothing to shame what is great. Most of the time when God wants to do something great, He will pick the one who is nobody from nothing less and take them to somewhere. Hear the prayer of Hannah. Hannah says, He picked me, I was like an old cloth in the ashes. He washed me and purified me for me to be what I am today. Some of us, we don't deserve to be here. There were people who would speak good English. There were people who would pray hours and hours. We were elected by grace. We did not have clothes to go to church. We did not have clothes to go to school. We did not have people to pay for our school fees. Just like me, students were donating 1 rand each day for me to pay my school fees. I don't deserve to be here, but I was elected by grace. That is why, if I'm elected by grace, I cannot be dethroned by grace. If grace elevates you, grace sustains you. But if you elevate yourself, then yourself, by yourself, throw yourself down. You will demote yourself. But if God elevates you, nobody can bring you down. Listen to this. Where you are today, nobody will bring you down. I decree and I declare that instead you are going up. That season of your prison time is now over. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. David says, we are like those who are dreaming. When the Lord took us as captives from captivity into our land. What is that thing as the apostles have? Don't neglect your ladders. Are you understanding? concerning that. The same Mephibosheth, who was there in Lodibar. God can still use.
Thank you, Father.
Hallelujah. God can use anything for His glory. When He chose David, He says to Samuel, don't look at the outward appearance, but look at the inside. Look at the destiny of the person. Many people will judge you based on what they see in you. Many people will judge you based on what you have today. But there is a God in heaven who will not judge you and judge you by who you are today or what you are today. The scales of heaven, the scales of heaven are not like the scales of men. Because God looks at the inside. Same David was leading sheep outside there. Same David was a shepherd. Was elevated to a higher position. I want to pray for you today. Because whosoever forgot you, they will remember you. In Jesus' mighty name. Whosoever it is that forgot you, they will remember you now. And as they come back, the Lord will use them as step ladders to destiny. And I pray that your eyes will be open, that you will see and discern your step ladder to greatness. When you find a person who is a step ladder, don't lose that person. Don't leave that person. Happy grace. I'm introducing a new season in your lives. There's a ladder of greatness that the Lord has placed before us. Remember these words. There's a ladder of greatness that the Lord has positioned for our greatness. Every grace, I'm a prophet, I'm telling you. There's a ladder of greatness that the Lord has put in Erodesa Valley. There's a ladder of greatness that the Lord has put for our elevation. May God help you to discern that ladder. May God cause your eyes to open, that you will see the ladder. You will not be where you are forever. You will not be the same level forever. Because your God, my God, is the lifter of men. Let us all pray. My Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we give you praise, we give you glory. Let's all pray. Let's all pray. Pray that the Lord will show you those ladders. Pray that the Lord will show you those ladders.
Zela ma kosa ya atepeli ateli. Zenamra ateli ya tala prateisha ateli. Rofeisha antakapala. Zedede shika pata. Rokodo suka palikata. Emendo kosuka. Parizo donta kapalikata. Zela ma sataya kosa ya. 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 Zela ma sataya k